Just a quick video on how to use the diagonal rule. Use this table here to write the electron configurations for elements on the periodic table. So let's just start with an example. We have sodium here. This is from the periodic table. Its atomic number is 11. That means it has 11 protons, but with elements on the periodic table, they're neutral. So the atomic number also equals the number of electrons. So we have 11 electrons, and we're going to spread them around the nucleus. We start with 1s. And S can hold up to 2. So let's put 2 electrons there. Then we go to 2S. And again, S can hold up to 2. So far we've used 2 plus 2, 4. We have 11. So we go to 2P. P can hold up to 6. So we'll put 6 there. We have 10. We only need one more. Down to our 3S. And we said S can hold 2, but we only need 1 to get 11. That's the electron configuration for sodium. So now you try one, calcium. So this is what you should have ended up for calcium. And note, if you count all of these up, you'll get 20. Let's look at the diagram for the diagonal rule in a little bit different format. So this is the same thing. It just kind of shows you how we're circling back around again to get the electron configurations. So let's try just one more. Chlorine. And again, all these numbers here, they add up to 17. So that's how you use this diagonal rule diagram to write electron configurations. There are links at the end of this video on how you can use just the periodic table to do this, as well as some information about ions and links to images of these tables I used here. This is Dr. B. Thanks for watching.